Welcome back to my channel, everyone, and thank you for joining me. Today's video is somewhat different to what I usually publish on my channel, but those of you who have kindly watched many previous videos, you will know that family history plays a big part in the videos that Yhana and I create. This new video is related to the research of my family history, but more importantly, our genetic family history and the Y DNA that exists through my paternal lineage. So please forgive me if this video is a little too in-depth, as genetic DNA is a difficult subject to follow, but an incredible tool to use for genealogy. I've been researching my family history for 25 years, and during that time, I have built a tree which consists of no less than 52,000 family members, and the branches of my tree date back to the Middle Ages. The tree also includes branches that relate to legendary, mythological, and biblical lineages, which is an area I am fascinated in due to my love of how people grew to understand the world around them and their understanding of where we came from, which has intrigued humankind for thousands of years. This video is part of a new series called Origins, and created as a means to further my research with my ancestry. These videos in particular will become a part of my websites and blogs, of which I have maintained and managed for several years. I have several videos planned, which I will explain further at the end of the video. Currently, I am undergoing a project to identify as many surnames that share my paternal haplogroup, which is R-YP417. This haplogroup is relatively young in terms of DNA and broke away from its parents' line around the time of Jesus. So we are looking at 0 CE. My haplogroup parent line is L1029 and dates back to 1200 BCE, so is Bronze Age in origin. This haplogroup is the forefather of three separate subclasses, including my own. One being the Leshites, which was a Bronze Age Slavic tribe that lived in Poland and Ukraine, and consists of the haplogroups RYP444 and RYP263, and my own haplogroup RYP417, which again is a Slavic DNA group and is shared by many men who are either Russian or Ukrainian. My DNA is dominated by Eastern Slavs, and as mentioned before, is aged about 2,000 years. RYP417 is shared with 54% of the Russian population, 16% of the Ukrainian population, 13% of Romania, 6% of Poland, and mixed by 8% with neighbouring countries. Now, my grandfather, Jan Kuta, was born in 1924 in Kumano, Eastern Galicia, which is an area of land created during the breakup of Poland in 1769. The land was border territory and fought over by many neighbouring countries. Today, it is divided between Ukraine, Poland, and Slovakia. Kumano itself, alongside nearby Lviv, also known as Lvov or Lemberg, depending on where you came from, now belongs to the Ukrainian people. The religion for this area is made up of Greek Catholic and Roman Catholic, and before World War II had a huge population of Jewish peoples, my father's autosomal paternal DNA is divided between his English mother and his Galician father. His Galician side is broken down as follows: 42% Eastern European, and his ancestral community is shared between southeast Poland, northwest Ukraine, which is an area that incorporates both Lviv and Krakow, and he belongs to the Ukrainian community and northeastern Romania. The final 8% of his paternal DNA is Scandinavian, as we descend from the Schwede family, which pretty much means somebody from Sweden. I'm going to share a few family photos from my Kuta family to add a personal touch to this video and hopefully assist in reaching out to family members that share that male haplogroup RYP417, and those who share my surname and all of the variations which are known. Many of these surname variations may not share the same Y DNA, and their meaning could be very different, but they are phonetically similar. These variations include Kuta, which is my own surname, Kuti, Kutovsky, which is a surname I believe that the Kuta family actually descend from, Kaita, which is a Ukrainian version of Kuta, Kut, Kutovo, Kutovi, Kula, Kutei, Kuta, and Kutaz. There may be a lot more variations of his surname, but my goal is to see if we all share that same male haplogroup, RYP417, and also identify other surnames that descend from that same ancestral forefather who was born sometime in the last 2,000 years. Our shared surname and variations has been found within Roman Catholic, Greek Catholic, and Jewish families. Our shared tree extends across many Slavic countries and Israel, and in more recent years across Western Europe, including France, Belgium, England, and in the United States of America. The name Kuta is also locational, and there are villages that share that word. There are four Kuta lakes in Poland and Kuta River that runs through Siberia. In ancient times, it was also the name of an ancient Babylonian city that existed before 2254 BCE. The ancient city was called Kuta or Kufa and was part of the Mesopotamian civilization. It was here in this city that the phrase, an eye for an eye, came into existence. It has also been suggested that the surname Kut is descended from King Hezekiah, who was the 13th king of Judah and born 741 BCE. This king belongs to the house of David. If correct, then the surname Kut belongs to the Davidic line and was a tribe of Judah. So Kut, for instance, most likely follows a very different Y DNA haplogroup than my own. My own autosomal DNA does include Coptic Egyptian, so a connection with Egypt and Israel does exist in the long forgotten past. Whether this strand of DNA is paternal or maternal has not yet been established. It could be either. Maternally, there is an old story in my family history through which we apparently descend from a Byzantine prince that was exiled to the Isle of Wight when his kingdom collapsed. Some of his male descendants still use the self-titled word of prince, although Debrett's, for instance, refused to acknowledge the lineage in the peerage of England. With further regard to my Y DNA haplogroup, it is believed that RYP417 broke away from its parent line as a genetic mutation, as mentioned previously, occurring about 2,000 years ago. This small group of people that male descendants of the haplogroup RYP417 descend are believed to have been part of a Zarebrenitsi culture, which is possibly connected to the pre-Slavic ancestors of early Slavs, proto-Slavs, with possible links to the peoples of the Dnieper Basin. The culture was influenced by the Latine culture and the nomads of the steppes, the Skinfians and the Sarmatians. The Skinfian and Sarmatian influence is evident, especially in pottery, weaponry, and domestic and personal objects used by the Srebrenica people. By the 3rd century AD, central late Srebrenica sites rearranged into the so-called Kiev culture, whilst the westernmost areas were integrated into the Wilbark culture. I find these ancestral links very interesting, as it gives me precise cultures that my male ancestors most likely descended from in the last 2,000 years. For someone like myself, who has a big interest in prehistory, those links to Bronze and Iron Age cultures is very fascinating. This is a DNA project and name study in order to identify connections between families and that all-important haplogroup R-YP417. I am mostly interested in those more recent genetic DNA mutations rather than the older groups, as we all belong to the same pliogenetic tree. This video is going to be published here on YouTube and shared across my websites and media pages. The following DNA origin videos I have planned includes my maternal haplogroup, K1A1A, and the following haplogroups that I have identified, of which belong to my ancestors, including IS17250, RC2S2509, K1BA1A, RM269, and 1Z138. That last one is an interesting one, as the DNA is Viking in origin. So if you're interested in genetic DNA, then please watch out for those forthcoming videos. I have included my email address in the description of this video, so please do get in touch if you can help with this project. I will finish the video with the short story of Gorski Zala, which tells the story of how my grandfather, Jan Kuta, came to leave his homeland in the 1930s. A big thank you for joining me. Stay safe, keep well, and bye for now. Bye, everybody. February 11th, 1939. A deep frost had set firmly across the eastern European province of Galicia. It was reportedly minus 30 Celsius, and the deportation of Poles in the boundary lands had begun. Gunshots were heard across Lvov and Kamano, and panic was already setting in. The Ukrainian armed soldiers arrived early hours of the morning and demanded that all Poles surrender their homes, livestock, and possessions. There was no compassion. They had less than an hour to pack and leave. With only what they could, they took warm blankets and a little food. Some were not even afforded this luxury. Trains at Kamano and Lvov were waiting. It was so cold, children were reportedly found frozen to death and corpses were piling up on station platforms. This is how our displaced Polish families were forced to leave their homeland. But through that pain, the cold, the hunger, the absolution that may never be found, the Polish men, women and children found their voice. In every train station from Lvov to Kamano, singing was heard. No music, just thousands of voices that carried across Kamano and Lvov. The emotion, their faith, their sorrow, the song they sung was Gorski Zala.